Hello, hopefully everyone can see my screen now. Thanks for the introduction, David. So today I'm going to be talking a little bit about enhancing Power Platform solutions with Pro Code, and I'm going to go over some scenarios where you may want to introduce a bit of Pro Code into your Power Platform solutions. Now, before I get into that, just a little bit about myself. So it's Brian Archer. I'm currently working as a DevOps engineer, working across Power Platform and Azure. My background is as an infrastructure engineer. So before I stumbled across Power Platform, I was looking after all things infrastructure in terms of servers and networking equipment, that sort of thing. In terms of my work in Power Platform, I've worked across Canvas apps, model-driven apps, Power Automate, and a bit of Power Platform governance in there as well. So before we go on to why you might want to introduce some Pro Code into your Power Platform solution, I wanted to cover a bit about what we mean when we say Pro Code. So typically when referring to Pro Code, we're thinking about traditional coding languages like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and C Sharp. These are often referred to as Pro Code languages. Now, HTML typically used to build your site structure. CSS is used to style the website, and JavaScript is used to add interactivity. Now, Power Platform is commonly thought of as a low-code or no-code platform. However, it does offer a variety of ways to extend into the Pro Code world. Now, why might you want to bring some Pro Code into your Power Platform solution if you're not a traditional software developer? Why would you want to kind of go the extra step to bring in some Pro Code? Now, it does offer some benefits in terms of what you can get with out-of-the-box Power Platform components. So with Pro Code, bringing in things like custom HTML and CSS, you can create enhanced user interfaces and enhanced user experience. You can customize your branding and can achieve greater design consistency. With JavaScript, you can implement enhanced interactivity within your model-driven apps, and it also offers improved client-side logic performance over things like the out-of-the-box business rules. And again, going into the Pro Code world offers the ability to leverage third-party data sources using a whole variety of APIs out there that you can bring in through things like custom connectors. Another thing that Power Platform offers is the ability to integrate with Microsoft Azure resources. So not only can you bring in some Pro Code elements, you can extend your Power Platform solutions into the world of Azure, using things like function apps, logic apps, storing your Power Platform assets and things like storage accounts. And also, you might want to bring in some Pro Code to enhance your own skills as a Power Platform professional and make yourself more desirable in the job market. Typically now, companies that are recruiting for Power Platform specialists, yes, they want people that know their Canvas apps, their model-driven apps, their Power Pages and their Copilot, but also, they're also looking for people that have a bit of knowledge and experience of Pro Code as well. So I'm going to talk a bit about the ways in which we can enhance our Power Platform solutions using Pro Code. So let's start with Canvas apps. So Canvas apps offer a couple of different ways where we can bring in some Pro Code. So you can create custom UI using HTML and CSS. You can create some user interface effects that just aren't achievable without the box components. And again, speaking of custom components, you can use the Power Apps Component Framework, PCF, to build your own components completely from the ground up using TypeScript as well. So that's a completely custom way of creating your own components. And using custom connectors, you can bring in data from third-party APIs as well. And I'm just going to jump into a quick demonstration of a Canvas app that's got a few pro code elements. Let me just drag this across to my screen. So I've got a couple of screens here that's got a couple of different, just small examples of some of the things you can achieve with a little bit of pro code. So what we've got here is a PCF component that just adds a glow effect around this text. Now, as you can see, nothing particularly spectacular. But this is built in PCF. It's just something you couldn't achieve with out-of-the-box Canvas app components, but you can achieve quite straightforward in PCF components. Again, similarly, another PCF component that you couldn't necessarily achieve with built-in components. This is a confetti component. And the interesting thing about this component is it actually, there's a property called spread where you can set the spread of the confetti. So not only can you build custom components that display static things, you can make your custom components dynamic and they can take in custom properties as well. And the next screen, I've got some UI effects that you can achieve using a little bit of HTML and CSS. So a little bit of gloss morphism effect here, where we've got some HTML text labels, and then we've got overlaid on top of the background, so you can still see the background, so it's creating this nice blur effect. And again, something not necessarily achievable without the box components. And down here, we've just got a nice gradient component, creating that gradient of colors as well. Again, these are just some simple UI effects that you can achieve using a little bit of HTML and CSS. Now, if we go back to my presentation, next on the list is model-driven apps. Now, with model-driven apps and pro code, we're typically looking at JavaScript and ways that we can bring JavaScript into our model-driven apps. And there's a couple of different ways we can do that. Firstly, we've got custom command buttons. So that's where you can create a button within your model-driven app forum. When you click on that button, it'll go and execute some JavaScript code. Now, that could be doing a whole variety of things that you can do in JavaScript. That could be going and, you know, talking to other third-party systems. It could be executing some logic, kind of anything that you can do within JavaScript. You can have that can execute on click of a custom command button. You can also run custom logic using JavaScript on events that happen in a model-driven app. So events like onForm load, onForm save, you can write some JavaScript and that'll execute on those events. And implementing JavaScript gives a bit more flexibility when compared to business rules, so you can implement more complex logic that's perhaps not achievable using out-of-the-box business rules. And you've also got the ability to implement dynamic interactive elements, and you've also got improved performance by minimizing server-side processing. And I will jump over to another demonstration of a model-driven app. Hey, let me just bring my screen back across. So what we've got here is a help desk application that's a model-driven app. So we've got a list of cases here. Now, if I click into one of those cases, we should see the first example of some JavaScript code that runs on form load. We've got a notification that pops up, and that contains some details that's specific to this organization that's logged this case. So within this organization record, there's a field called customer notes that has some notes about the customer. And each time we open a case that's related to that customer, we get the technician that's dealing with the case gets a notification containing those notes. Another example of implementing JavaScript is custom command buttons. So I've got a button up here called assign to me. Now, when I click this button, it will automatically assign the case to the currently logged in user. And another example of some custom logic within JavaScript is to show and hide some fields on a model-driven form. So if I mark that as resolved, you'll see now we get this extra section here. And again, that's all done using some custom JavaScript. So this just gives you an idea of how you can achieve certain interactive elements using JavaScript that you can't necessarily achieve with out-of-the-box business rules. And if I go back to my demonstration, the last Power Platform component I wanted to talk about is Power Pages and how we can implement Pro Code in Power Pages. Now, for anyone that's not familiar with Power Pages, it essentially offers the ability to build and create fully functioning front-end web pages in a kind of Power Platform, low-code, no-code way, essentially. But the really cool thing about Power Pages is not only does it cater to low-code, no-code, it also gives you the ability to fully access the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript as you would with any other front-end web development project. So with that comes the ability to incorporate custom components from libraries like Bootstrap. You can completely design your own theme. So you get, again, you get full access to the CSS. So you can completely customize your own theme to suit whatever you need. And again, you can write your own custom logic in JavaScript just as you would for any other website. And like any other kind of web project, you can make calls to custom APIs. And I will bring over another quick demonstration of a Power Pages site. So what we have here is Power Pages site that I built. It's essentially a fictitious restaurant. So this is built in Power Pages, but using, you know, as I say, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So if we look at the menu tab and we just let the menu load, what we've got here is a custom Bootstrap component. That's the accordion. So for the menu, we've got this accordion component that expands these sections when we click on it for the different menu sections. And each of these images and descriptions of each menu item is coming from a Dataverse table. So this is using the Dataverse web API to talk to the backend Dataverse table from the Power Pages site. And these images are actually stored in an Azure blob storage account. So again, extending the site into the Azure world as well. If I look at the reservations page, I've got a custom reservations form. So this is for people to make reservations at the restaurant. And the good thing about doing a custom form is you can implement your own validation. So if I try and submit this, you'll see that there's some required fields here that need to be completed before we can submit the form. And the validation goes even further than that because I've got some validation running on the date and time. So it can't be, you can't choose a date before today effectively. So it can't be a date in the past. And the email also has to be in the format of an email address. So it's using a regex check to check that the email address is in the correct format. And similarly with a phone number. And if I quickly complete this form and submit it. Just do that now. Okay. Let me just submit that form just now. And what it's doing now is it's going and, or what it should be doing is it's going and checking availability by using a Power Automate flow. And then it should pop open a notification that gives a success message if it's found essentially, if it's found a spot and the reservation's been successful, it should pop open a notification. There we go, reservation successful. So again, that's a custom notification message as well. So this just gives you an idea of how you can customize each element of your Power Pages site, so you can get really deep in that HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to completely customize essentially every aspect of your site. And if I go back over to my slides, so that all seems great, but what if, like me, you're not a traditional pro code developer? Well, the good thing about 2025 is it's never been easier, I think, to sort of get hands-on with these kind of tools and also to learn them. We've got many tools at our disposal now to help learn things like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and you don't have to be an expert in all of these areas to implement a small bit here and there in your Power Platform solutions. What you do, however, still need to do is have a solid understanding of the fundamentals of software development, so things like your data types, conditional logic, operators, all that kind of thing. You still need to have a solid understanding of that. And then to build on that, we have tools today like Copilot, where you can get quite far by prompting your favorite AI agent to ask it for snippets of HTML and JavaScript and CSS. And whilst it might not always produce the finished article, generally it'll get you far enough that if you understand those fundamentals, you can, get to where you want to get to with the help of your AI agent. So it's not, if you want to implement some pro code in your Power Platform solution, it's not necessary to be from a purely software development background. As long as you understand the fundamentals, you can generally get quite far. And before I finish up, I just wanted to point you to some resources that I used to help me when I was kind of looking into implementing some pro code and Power Platform solutions. So firstly, we've got Traversy Media on YouTube. He's got some pretty good beginner guides to things like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Howding Rashid, he did a good series called Solution Sunday, where he's got three or four different use cases for implementing JavaScript in a model-driven app, and you can follow it through in your own environment. And then that was one of the first things I stumbled across when I was looking at JavaScript and model-driven apps. It really opens your eyes and you see what's possible by implementing just a small bit of JavaScript into a model-driven app. And if you want to practice your CSS, I found a nice little game that sort of gamifies learning CSS. So that was quite fun to learn your CSS. And if you want to generate some of those CSS glass morphism effects that I showed, there's a nice little link there that'll generate them for you, and that gives you, that just produces the CSS that you can copy and paste into your Canvas app. And thank you for your time, and I'll pass back over to David.